I'm Ellie Setback, reporting.
So Brandon Kraus, sometimes I see fighters that spend so much time on strength and conditioning because they believe they're already good fighters, they already know how to fight. And sometimes fighters that I know do 100% boxing and zero strength and conditioning because that's the old school thought. Just run 3 miles, you don't need to lift a weight.
Well, no, it's funny because those guys that don't do strength and conditioning, they do it all the time. They're throwing med balls, they're doing push-ups, they're doing burpees. They do all sorts of resistance training. They just don't know that they're doing resistance training because they're not competent on what that is, right? So there, I think every fighter, without a doubt, is doing some sort of strength training, and it doesn't necessarily have to be with, iron, you know?
But sometimes I've seen fighters, especially from Mexico, who look like they haven't lifted a weight in their life, but they're knockout artists. They're not ripped, they're not bulky, they don't look like they're muscular, they don't look like boxers, but they kick ass like crazy.
And it's weird, when you watch these guys on TV, you totally get the sense of, wow, this guy just looks real thin, he doesn't look an athlete. But Ellie, you know for a fact, when you meet these guys in real life, even the guys that don't have the great physiques on TV, when you meet them in real life, you can totally tell they are athletes.
So Brandon, what would you tell fighters who spend 98%, 95% of the time strength and conditioning, cardio, but put 10% boxing or 5%?
Well, you're not going to excel as a boxer that way.
But they'll be in great shape?
But they'll be in great shape.
Isn't being in shape 90% of it? Good conditioning? Because that's about how good of a fighter you are.
How about this? Your conditioning is the only thing you're in control of. Anything else, you know, is in the universe of ever changing, right? The theater of the unexpected. The only thing you can be absolutely sure of is that you're in shape.
So what should fighters focus on? Boxing, strength and conditioning, or is it 50-50, is it 60-40? How do you divide it?
At different times in your boxing career, it's going to represent different things. Boxing should be the mainstay of your training. Should be boxing and technique and skills and tactics and strategies and ring IQ and all that type of stuff. And this, for a competitive boxer, should only supplement your boxing training.
Do you think 70-30? Is that what it sounds like?
I don't have that kind of answer
for you. But you're a fighter, Jesse Martinez, 7-0. How much time does he spend lifting weights, running, push-ups?
In comparison to his boxing, he's probably doing we box for 2 hours. This is in camp. All right, so we'll box for 2 hours. He'll do an hour run earlier that day, and then he'll do an hour 45 minutes to an hour strength training.
Every day?
6 days a week.
That's a lot?
Well, that's during camp.
Yeah.
I guess like if you looked at it as a volume, just a training log, you would say that half the time was spent boxing and half the time.
Yeah, it sounds like 55.
But that's not true though, because that hour long run is just kind of mindless. As a real percentage, it doesn't occupy that much of his mental space. The majority of his mental effort is boxing wise.
So
the vast majority.
Focus on boxing, but be in shape.
Sure.
Do you need a lot of muscles to be a good fighter?
No.
You need any muscles to be a good fighter.
Yes. Without any muscles, you would just be laying there, unable to move, just a bag of bones.
Do you need to look like Mr. Olympia to be a good fighter?
No, in fact, that's going to probably be deter you from being a good fighter to have that much muscle.
You're going
to
gas out, right?
The more muscle you have, the more energy it takes to operate. That's why boxers don't look like bodybuilders. And that's, you ever notice, why is the top weight class only 200 pounds, right? Wait, and out on the street, there's guys well over 200 pounds everywhere, right? But when you're in killer shape, a human being just isn't that big.
A lot of MMA fighters look like bodybuilders.
Yeah, it's a different, they need to have that strength for wrestling and things like that. It's not, their physiques are always going to be different than a boxer.
All right, there you have it. Stay tuned, Brandon Kraus. Now, last thing.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Setback, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Setback. And you can follow me on Instagram, @Ellie Setback.